Okay, so time check. It's already 6:30 po. So let's start. So good evening to each and everyone. Mayap abengi po sa mga kasama kong kapampangan. Okay, so magandang gabi po sa ating lahat. So kumusta na po kayo? So I hope na sana po ay nasa mabuti po tayong mga kalagayan. Good health, even though that this kind of pandemic po. No? So before we start our day two of our asking the right questions, revisiting the crucial parts in conceptualizing a quantitative study, let us be reminded of some etiquettes. First, go to a quiet place para mas medyo focus po tayo. Mute the line. So mamaya po may mga program rules pa rin po tayo. And then, pay attention in this webinar. Take notes para hindi natin makalimutan yung mga iba natin kailangan o importanteng matututunan natin sa ating speaker. And participate. So these are the different etiquettes so that we can have a very fruitful session with our speaker. And to start with, let us all feel the presence of the Lord in this prayer.
In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, we come to you today asking for your guidance, wisdom, and support as we begin this seminar. Help us to engage in meaningful discussion, allow us to grow closer as a group, and nurture the bonds of community. Fill us with your grace, Lord God, as we make decisions that might affect ETCOR, embracing the culture of research. And continue to remind us that all that we do here today, all that we accomplish, is for the pursuit of truth, for the greater glory of you, and for the service of humanity. We ask these things in your name. Amen.
Amen. So again, good evening to each and everyone. For this second day of our webinar for asking the right questions, revisiting the crucial parts in conceptualizing a quantitative study, I would like to introduce myself as your moderator. So I am Rigette Ryan S. Ramos, the school head of Bacolor High School, one of the baby secondary schools in the municipality of Bacolor in the school's division office of Pampanga. And as we all know, that this event is an initiative of ETCOR, the Educational Research Center, under its advocacy project Sagip Mananaliksik for Everyone, which main aim is to help the researchers, either the students and professionals all over the country, especially during this time of pandemic. And also, we have Project Sagip Mananaliksik One-on-One. Both projects are with all DepEd advisories. And to recognize, siyempre, our project overall coordinators for Project Sagip Mananaliksik for Everyone, we have Dr. Bernadette L. Harde. And for Project Sagip Mananaliksik One-on-One, we have Dr. Adrian Lawrence P. Carvajal. And especially, our Head of Research Consultant of ETCOR, Dr. Richard Sanchez. And likewise, I would like to recognize all the national, region, and division, city, provincial coordinators, and all the research consultants who are here present. And to welcome us all in this exciting learning experience, let me call Ma'am Angelyn C. D. Tioco, the Program Head of College of International Tourism and Hospitality Management of La Consolacion University, Philippines. Let's give her a virtual clap.
Hi, good evening, Doc. Am I audible?
Good evening, Doc.
A good day to everyone. I hope that everyone is doing well today. It's really a great pleasure to welcome each and every one of you. Thank you for making your time to be with our day two webinar. It is especially a great moment for all of us to have our lecturer today, who will share his expertise in providing us a step-by-step approach in asking the right questions, specifically to conceptualize a quantitative research study. As we all know, research is like a battle that we can win as long as we are prepared, we are organized, and we are systematized. In this occasion, on behalf of ETCOR, allow me to extend our gratitude for being with us today. Thank you so much, and mabuhay.
Thank you very much, Ma'am Angelyn, for that very wonderful welcome message to our participants. Before I introduce our wow na wow resource speaker, mamaya malalaman niyo bakit wow na wow resource speaker, no? Let me give you the program outline. So for this asking the right questions, revisiting the crucial parts in conceptualizing a quantitative study, so the focus here are the designs, a research use in a daily life, writes a research title, describes background of research, states research questions, indicates scope and delimitation of study, and presents written statement of the problem. And before I start, let me give you again the different house rules. So first, let us turn off the microphone. But if you can unmute it, no po, if you will be acknowledged, may or may not open your camera. But if you can, please open po para makita naman po namin yung mga magaganda at mga guwapo pong mga kasamahan namin dito sa ETCOR. And use as identification the acronym of your institution and your last and first name. Like for example, BHS Ramos Rigette. And lastly, questions or other thoughts may be typed in the chat box and to be entertained after the talk. So, to introduce our wow na wow resource speaker, no? So, he is a professor for business management and research and education for almost more than 20 years, an international and national manager experience for 10 years, for more than 10 years, published in referred and ISI journals, a multi-awarded researcher for 26 times, no? A research paper presenter and resource speaker engagement for more than 100 times, and a reviewer, editor of International Research Journal, a best research paper in the 2021 International Multidisciplinary Research Conference, a 2021 Global Leaders and Educators Award for Leadership and Research, an assessor of the Philippine Quality Awards, and the Dean of the Institute of Graduate Studies of San Sebastian College, Recoletos, Manila, Philippines. Our resource speaker in his title, Research Driven Life, Crucial Questions to Start Your Research Journey. Friends, let us welcome Dr. Adrian Lawrence P. Carvajal. Let's give him a big round of applause.
Thank you, Dr. Ramos. Can you hear me, Dr. Ramos?
Well, medyo, ano po yung internet niyo po ata sa end po ninyo?
Hello, Dr. Ramos?
Yes po, sir.
Medyo internet, okay, sige. Please bear with my connection. Globe po yun. So I'll try as much to shorten the discussion. Sige po. I'll be sharing po.
Yes po, Doc.
My PowerPoint that I have prepared. Sige po. Ako na lang po, sir. Okay. Dr. Ramos?
Yes po, Doc.
Is my PowerPoint already?
Yes po, Doc.
Presented? Ito na po yun.
Yes po, Doc. Sige po. Naka-flash na po, Doc.
Hello po. Thank you. Good evening, everyone. Good evening to the research consultants. Apo, research consultants who are here today, this evening. I'll be top as your resource speaker for today. I'll be having a short of customizing the title of my presentation. So it's a research-driven life, the crucial questions to start your research journey. So I'm, well, at editor, si Dr. Rigette Ryan S. Ramos.
Parang nawala ata si Doc.
Nawala siya, sir.
Apo. Doc, Adrian.
Amin po si sir.
Nawala okay. Po yung
inyong sir, present- nawala ako. Oo. I need to...
Apo. Ako na lang po yung mag-screen, mag-share ng screen, Doc.
Magta-transfer lang po. Sige po, sir. Transfer to another Wi-Fi connection. Sige.
Okay po, sige po daw. Wait ka po namin. Apo. So for this second day of our webinar po, no? Again, we would like to recognize our participants from the national, regional, city divisions and provincial research consultants and coordinators po natin na nandito. Okay? I can see also some of friends in the DepEd, no po. So kumusta naman po yung ating ano mga school forms? Sana po patapos na po tayo, no? Okay na po tayo, Doc? Nasa ano na po kasi tayo yung mga kasamahan sa DepEd, nasa crucial week na po tayo because we are in the last week of our school year.
Okay. Ito yung walang hingahan na week, no, sir?
Ang dami ko natapos na virtual. Puro virtual lahat tayo. Okay? And even I, yung pong internet connection ko po so dito po, ay talagang dinadalangin na sana'y hindi po mawala yung ating connection po para hindi po mawala yung ating conversation with our webinar. So, meron po tayo from SDO Antipolo. We have also from SDO, wait lang, from Leyte. No po, good evening po. And meron din po tayo from SDO Cotabato Division. Welcome po sa ating day 2 of our webinar po. Ayan. Yan, Doc. Nakikita na po namin yung presentation po ninyo, Doc.
Wow, apologies. Apologies po. Sorry po. Sorry po. Sige, I'll be, I might have intermittent connection, so bear with me. So, yun po yun. So, I'm acknowledging now Professor Angelyn Tioco, who has given the good opening remarks, as well as the one that will give the closing remarks, Dr. Francis Gumawa, who's going to be part of this team of day 2. So thank you for being a part of this preparation for this day 2 webinar. Allow me to share the images of endearment. Usually I start with the images of endearment that I have. So the ETCOR is, this is the organization that I particularly like. It's a good organization with good research consultants who unselfishly share their expertise and their time in propagating a good research culture in their schools and in the entire Philippines. So yun po yun. So it's a good organization. So for those who are, I belong to San Sebastian. There's a picture of San Sebastian Minor Basilica. It's known as the only Asian metal church for the entire Asia. So At the back of that church will be my school, the San Sebastian College Recoletos, Manila. Another picture is here, that's sa Pangasinan because I'm a native in Pangasinan. Also, if you have time, pag wala ng pandemic, you can visit our province in Pangasinan. A dear professor who have just passed away, si Dr. Jason Lanon. So I mentioned that in the services that we have, I'm invited to talk, but I'm going to deliver this talk in honor of his memory. So Dr. Jason Lanon, God bless and have a good journey ahead. Okay, I'll have a disclaimer that this talk wishes not to supplant learning that was given by the advisors of the students, so because this talk is intended for the students, but I have a notion now that the majority of my participants that we have right now will be the research consultants or professors or teachers or academicians. So this this webinar is to supplant the learning that we have. Okay, so I'm now going to dive on the topic that I have, and I have particularly customized my title into Driven Life, Critical or Crucial Questions to Start Your Research Journey. If you're going to take note, it has an allusion to a certain book. If you're familiar with the Purpose-Driven Life, it's a good book by Rick Warren that espouses that to live our life, we should have a certain purpose, a north pole, a direction. Hello po?
Yan po.
Nawawala so, po ulit ako.
Yan, okay na po. Kanina po medyo nagaano.
Doc Ramos?
Yes po, Doc.
Am I still okay?
Yes po, Doc. Ngayon po, okay na po yung...
I have... Okay na po.
Okay na po yung audio nyo ngayon, Doc.
I sounded like a robot, so pasensya na po.
Opo.
If you're wondering, if you're wondering what connection do I have a globe connection. I have a globe connection. So balik po tayo dito. So it's an allusion to a certain book, The Purpose-Driven Life. So if we're going to live our life, can it be a research-driven life?
Hello, nawala na naman po si Doc Carvajal. Siguro nagkakaroon po talaga siya ng ano ng problema sa connection po natin.
Yes.
Siguro Doc, uh-oh, ano po, para
sir, can you show my PowerPoint presentation?
Yes po, Doc.
Sige po, ikaw na lang. Baka nahirapan.
At the same time po, life, Doc, baka po yung video po ninyo, siguro po,
yes,
kahit
yes,
gusto namin po makita yung pagwapuan mo, mamaya na lang.
Sige po, sige po. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Ryan Ramos. Tama ka dyan. I was having intermittent connection this morning. I have a long meeting. I have around 9 to 12:30 meeting. It was not intermittent. It was not intermittent. Ngayon lang ako nagkakaroon ng intermittent connection. So, maaaring tama ka. The video streaming is taxing the connection that I have. I am now on. Sige po, sir. Sige po. So, next slide. Okay, sir, diyan muna tayo. Above. Sige po. Prior slide, sir. Yes, thank you. So, I made the customization of my title into a research-driven life because of a certain book, The Purpose-Driven Life. So we can live our life also that is driven by research. No? We can be guided by research. We can be directed by research. We can enrich our lives with research. If you have unearthed the origin of the book of Dr. Stephen Covey, The 7 Habits of Highly Effective People, this is actually his dissertation, then becoming a book. So originally, this is his work, is his research, doctoral dissertation, and it has come into fruition as a book. also the same concept has happened to the book of Causes and Posner. Ito yung the leadership challenge. They surveyed around 70,000 managers and leaders in the corporate world, and they came out with this book, The Leadership Challenge. Dito, dinocument yung 5 exemplary practices of leadership. So, ito po yun. Next slide, Dr. Ryan. So, including this one, recently we have this pandemic. You know, this picture is actually the recent news that is given last June 28, 2021. It was a professor who helped design the COVID vaccine gets a standing ovation in a Wimbledon tennis match. So lahat dyan nakatayo, mayroong isa doon na nasa baba who is being given the standing ovation. One of the contributors, one of the professors or designers of their COVID vaccine. So even in this time of pandemic, research plays a very important role in shaping our lives, in directing our lives, in enriching our lives, in bettering our lives. So our life is actually a research-driven life. So research-driven life. So thank you, Dr. Ryan. Sige po, next slide na po. Okay. So I'll be concentrating on the talk on choosing, how do you choose the best research topic? So you can join in the discussion later. Paano ba tayo dapat magkaroon ng isang best research? Isang best or significantly good research topic? Sige po. Dr. Ryan, sige po. The talk was given before in the National Research Assembly of Researchers for all Recoletos schools. So in this talk, so the research topic selection, whenever we're going to have this already in our plate, it's a decision-making process that is quite very stressful and time-consuming. So medyo, hindi lang medyo, no? It's proven already that when we're going to begin the research, we have a big wall already, and that wall will be a decision that has to be made when it comes to the topic selection. And it's quite stressful and very time consuming. Dr. Ryan, sige po. So other than stressful, time consuming, this decision-making process is also very complex. So why is it complex? Because it will take into account critical sources or factors from the students or researchers, as well as for their advisors. So an example of the critical sources that we are going to have, whenever we're going to have a research, we're going to start with our research journey, will be the complexity of these critical sources and factors. An example will be our own selves. Are we capable of doing such research in this discipline? Our companions in the research, if we're doing a group research, the complexity of the research topic, our finances also is going to be considered. Our physical attributes, can we do the floating, or can we ask for help of doing the survey questionnaire or interview guide? So these are among the other critical factors and that is going to be considered when you're going to consider a topic selection. Dr. Ryan, sige po. Thank you once again. Okay. I'll be giving 2 frameworks for choosing the best research topic. I do not know if you have heard it already. So letter A here is the finer framework, and letter B will be the 5W1H framework for choosing the best research topic. So let's start with the finer framework. This was given by Praharaj 2020. So this one is the finer framework. The finer here stands for the feasible, or being feasible, the work that is being feasible, interesting, novel, ethical, and relevant. So it's a good framework to identify and establish good research questions we can examine each question under this framework, and that allows one to evaluate if the paper that we're going to conceptualize has a scientific merit. So it's a good framework to be able to judge the paper or the research that we're going to start has good scientific merit. Sige po, Doc Ryan. Let's start with the feasibility. The feasibility here talks about when we evaluate our topic, it should be evaluated in terms of the time required. So how long are you, can you finish the research? How long is given to you to be able to finish the research? So what's your timeline now? What's the scope? So it's either this one is a city-wide in scope, province-wide, region-wide, or nationwide, or international in scope, your research. What are your available funds? The other resources that you're going to have, and the expertise of you or the track that you're going to have. So if you're enrolled in a certain discipline, or the expertise of your advisor is also going to be considered. So is it feasible now, considering this topic that you're going to pursue? Reasonable time frame in place of work. So the reasonable time frame also is going to be considered. The infrastructure, and as well as the human resources that are going to be involved. So if you're doing a group research, you're going to consider other human resources, other persons with you. Or if you're doing a funded research, can you tap enumerators to be able to make the survey questionnaire, do the survey questionnaire for you, or are you able to tap other experts to do the interview guide for you, the focus group discussions, or the key informants interview for you? You need to consider also the pool of subjects. This has something to do with your respondents or participants. Can they be accessed? Do you have limitation on the access of these respondents? For example, if these are children, so you need to consider also that possibility. The collaborators and the team members in your group research can also be considered, and it can contribute to the feasibility, the possibility of the completion of your research. Next slide, Doc Ryan. Okay. These are examples of the research that we have conducted. So when we talk about the feasibility, we have done the research on the Sierra Madre. So that's a big big mountain that we went into, and we climbed that mountain. No? Even if it's raining, we are able to go there. So ito po yun. So our work there is trying to innovate the community, innovating community organizing and mentoring as strategies for poverty alleviation for the protection and conservation of the environment. So this is a CHED-funded research with Miriam College that was conducted around 10 years ago pa. So I'm trying to at least make a connection. Is this work feasible? No, it became also feasible because it's a group research, and we were able to connect with a certain community that help us connect with our pool of subjects. The intention of this research is actually to improve their livelihood, to convert their kaingin methods. So their way of life is kaingin, meaning they burn trees for living. They cut and burn trees for living and turn it into yung uling, and provide them with another alternative livelihood. So that's the aim for this one. If you're going to ask, if we climb that mountain, or if we went there to the community, we went there to the community. Po. So naging feasible naman to. Pero mahirap. Mahirap po to. So there are instances that you're going to be required to go there, especially for the tourism researches. No? When they try to discover the tourism development plans of a certain tourism destination, they need to go there, experience also the setting or the local, the research local. So another one that is big in scope that we have conducted will be the support the employment and livelihood of persons with disabilities. Ito yung SELP program that was conducted in Metro Manila, Metro Cebu, and Metro Davao. So this was wide in scope, And it became only feasible because we have tapped into the enumerators. We have tapped an NGO partner that has connections for PWD organizations in Metro Manila, Metro Cebu, and Metro Davao. So that makes the data gathering process much easier and feasible. Kung wala po talaga yun, ay mahirap po talaga na gawin yung research na to. So three places, three big places, and the pool of subjects or respondents will be the PWD. So we have tapped into, it's a good thing that the in the group research, the group that we have, the group also belongs to one of the PWD members. So yun po yun. Kasama po sila. Sige po. Doc Ryan, sige po. Okay, finer. So the I here stands for interesting. So you should have a genuine interest in the topic. It should personally and professionally be rewarding, and it should be a source of motivation for you. I think for every topic that we're going to have, there should be an interest of the researcher. We should have. Oh, sige, may chat si Dr. Richard. So, meron po talagang interest. So, naka-ingrain ka agad na meron interest yung researcher. Well, in our case, if we are going to do the research, dapat may interest ka on the certain topic. So, dapat interesting. No? Hindi interesting sa secondary, yung interesting sa iba. It should be interesting sa'yo because that will fuel your energy, fuel your desire to finish the whole research. You should not be motivated by others, no, yung others' interest. You should be motivated by your genuine interest first. So that's number one, interest muna. Next, personally and professionally rewarding. So this one, what is it for you now, the research? So it should be personally rewarding too. The mere completion, it's for a degree completion. So other than that, yung search for knowledge and the quench of your thirst for such knowledge should be personally rewarding. Professionally rewarding also, kung meron po siyang, well, if you can present it, you have funding for such, it can be credited in your CV, it can be counted as one of your accomplishments also, when you're able to finish a research and present it and publish it. So it's professionally rewarding also. The source of motivation, when you look back on your researches or on your topics that you have worked into, dapat isang source din to ng motivation. It's a source of pride for you that you have worked on such project, on such research project. So when you go back later on in your life, okay, we have done this research, and it can become a source of pride and a source of motivation for you. So that's a FI. Doc Ryan, next up po. So na N. Let's go to the N now. The finer. Ay, ito pa pala yung interesting. One of the interesting siguro yung quirks ko sa akin, no? I became interested in the banknotes and the coins. The coins that we have and the Philippine banknotes that we have. Ano to yung mga research na to? In the tourism and educational agenda of the Philippine banknotes. I presented it in the PRCTH organized by University of the Philippines. Marami ding natuwa dito kasi if you were accustomed to the design of the banknotes, the Philippine bills that we have, ito yung mga papel, you take for granted the designs. But the designs that are in place there sa Philippine banknotes or Philippine bills has certain purposes and it arouses certain emotions to the person holding such bill. So doon, no, I made the connection. Ano po yung mga nakalagay doon sa Philippine banknotes? What's the historical significance of such things? And what will be the parang architectural? Meron siyang framework na ginawa ko from, ano ba yung mga framework na yan? Ano yung mga fauna and flora na nalagay? What's the significance? Ano mga objects, symbols na nilagay? The portraits also. Ano mga symbols na nung naglalagay tayo ng mga portraits? Okay. So, isa yan na nilagay ko kasi ito yung mga pinaka-latest. Pero I have been working on the idea that money is the money performs the fifth function. So if you're in the business world, we have only four functions of money kasi. But this time, I'm trying to espouse that there is a fifth function of money, and that it tries to promote the legitimacy of the issuing country and its use as a media, mass media for communication. So that's the fifth function of money. Money performs such function. Whenever countries issue its money, it tries to communicate also its culture, its national identity. If you're going to have a comparison, nagkaroon din ng study, hindi ko na naisama dito. Nagkaroon kami ng comparison ng Philippine money with the other ASEAN money. So doon mo makikita na may kanya-kanya silang mini-message for their citizens and for the holders of the money. So meron po, may messages na binibigay. Okay. Ito naman yung sa coins, no? Other than the Philippine money, the bills, the paper bills that we have, or the banknotes, meron din akong interest dun sa coins. So I presented this one, also published it in the Journal of St. Paul University, Quezon City, and I also won yung best research paper dito. Yung minting meanings. Minting is the process of making the coins. So nagkaroon ng comparison between the new and the old coins. But if you're familiar with the old coins dati, these are the flora and fauna series. Doon yung nakikita sa likod. May makikita kayo sa likod ng mga animals, for example. There are fishes, 10 cents ay fishes, 50 cents before ay eagle, and the 1 peso coin ay Carabao. Ano yung mga meaning na binibigay noon when it was minted? Compared now, what is the meaning now of the coins that we have? Kasi may mga bago rin tayo mga coins. So it's different. May binibigay silang mga meanings. I could remember when I was a young professor, I taught logic before. Simple lang yan eh. Yung parang ginawa ko pa na game so before. Yung one carabao plus one carabao equals two coconuts. Simply because one peso coin, these are carabaos. Pero yung nakalagay sa likod kasi ng 2 peso coin is the coconut. So, one carabao and another carabao equals one coconut tree. So, parang ganun yung laro namin sa logic in my class before. When I was a young teacher before. So, I taught logic before as my first. These are the first subjects na tinuro ko before. Na-phase out na rin yun, yung logic as a class before. Okay po, nasa N na po tayo. N will be the novelty. Okay. Novelty. What's the good thing about research? I think na-define din to ng other research consultants. It's the generation of new knowledge. That's actually the stand of the innovation. Innovation is new and better application. So it's not just new, but it's better, no? Better than before. So the novelty of a research should lead to studies that result in new findings. There are many takes on going for new findings. Even if you are going to have the same study, but you are going to use different methods, you're going to have new findings. Different sample, you're going to yield new findings also. Also, you need to take note that in the novelty, you need to be aware of your background of research also, or RRL, to be able to determine what is the current discussion ng research topic that you are trying to start. So you need also to join the discussion, because the purpose of research is actually to join in the discussion of the scholars. So you do a research to be able to document your findings and contribute to the discussion of the scholars in the field. Ito pala, nasa second bullet point. You may have the same findings in different samples, improves the generalization of such. You can also improve the methodology if limitations have been identified in a certain research. You can also improve the methodology. One has conducted a quantitative study, You can conduct also a qualitative using the same, no? Using the same framework, and it can yield different results. The examination also of other variables is also going to be contributing to the novelty of your paper, especially us sa mga nagtapos ng dissertation, no? They are after this one. You need to, other than the variables that are already considered, you need to introduce another variable to be able to have your paper have the novelty that is aspired for by your the panel members or the examiners. So ito yun, hinahanap din namin to, other than the common variables or the common or the theory that you have used, you need to improve on the theory by introducing another variable. Identifying clear gaps in the literature results is also good. No? This is actually the start of novelty, knowing the research gaps. Kasi hindi pa talaga na-research, therefore, when you're doing the research that you have identified as a research gap, then you're offering something new. And you're offering something new to the scholarly discussion of the topic. Okay, novelty. Sir, nasa iyo pala, Dr. Ryan, nasa iyo pala ang slide present. Okay. This one is novel. When we started, we joined the bandwagon of researching COVID-19 pandemic. So we research on, this one is actually an offshoot already. Offshoot means may original research, tapos ito na yung parang anak niya. So we work on the customer-based tourism brand equity in times of COVID-19 pandemic. The Philippines in vlogging. So this work is with Dr. Badilla from University of the Philippines, Diliman, Professor Carl Castro from La Consolacion College, dito sa Manila yan, and Professor Maria Paz Castro from Our Lady of Fatima University. So we work on this paper. Actually, hanggang ngayon, nag-edit pa po kami ng papel namin for publication in Scopus. Si Dr. Badilla po in charge niyan. So ito po yung mga binigay niya mga task sa amin. So it's a good thing if you're going to be put in a group with like-minded persons who share your passion also in research. Ang maganda dito sa research na to, kaya maganda to, other than COVID-19 pandemic yung topic, will be vlogging is the source of our material. The research material that we have used is the videos that are uploaded by the vloggers in their YouTube. So ito yung naging bago sa amin. So napaka-novel to. It was received well when we presented this one. Kasi nga, dinocument namin ang vlogs nila. Talagang nanood po kami, no? We share, we assign persons, the vloggers, around 8, and we watch their videos, concentrating on their vlogs during the time of pandemic. So ano ba yung content noong at the time of pandemic ng kanilang vlogs? So talagang nagkaroon kami ng new method dito to document such a method na nagkaroon kami ng transcription pa. No, every word ay na-transcribe namin. And we watch the videos, mga around 18 to 24 hours yung video na pinanood namin to be able to produce this kind of research. At hindi pa tapos to, no? Pero ito'y bunga na lang, offshoot. Offshoot na lang po to. Kasi the original research that is home away from home. I think I presented it already from one of these talks. Yung home away from home, the tourist gaze of the foreign vloggers is subject for Scopus publication. So, yun po yun. Novel kasi medyo bago nga yung method. We did not go after a survey questionnaire or interview guide dito. We went after material that they have. At yun po yung ginamit namin na material. I think I have done another research na ang research material ko lang ay one book that contains the interviews of several businessmen, successful millionaires in the Philippines. So there's a book, I think yung Go Negosyo book, 50 sila. 50 Go Negosyo stories that became a material for me to be able to identify the work values of these millionaires that contributes to their success as an entrepreneur. So, yun pa yun. Isang research material din po yun. The material that I have used there is a book, pero dito, the material that we have used here are videos. Ito na yung parang uso ngayon, yung parang netnography na rin yata, no? Through the net, you can actually do your research, you know, harvesting the thoughts and ideas of netizens in their blogs, in their comments, etc. Okay po, sige po. Sir, okay na po. No, finer, E na po ako, E. Ethical. Well, other than the fine, the F-I-N, another consideration that we're going to have based on the finer framework will be ethical. When we consider research topic, we need to consider ethical guidelines in conducting the research. That includes here yung how do we treat the humans? Or kung merong animal research that is going to be involved, how is the treatment done? So, meron na po yan. Medyo mahigpit na rin po to based on the current trends of ethical guidelines that we have in our organizations. Mahigpit na rin po to, no? We are going to seek permission, consent, including data privacy in the ethical guidelines of research. Especially to the children. When we are going to have researches involving children and other special participants. Ito yung mga from PWD sectors that has problems, certain problems that requires special consent from their guardian or parents. Kailangan gawin din po ito, no? Ethical. Also, ito yun. Kaya meron na po tayong in place. The informed consent to participate in research should also be in place when we conduct the research. Ethical. Okay po, sir. I think I have the last one relevant, then I have the illustration. The last letter will be the R, and your work should be relevant. So it should pass the so what test. So why are you conducting the research? Blah blah blah. These are the common questions that are as of us, where if we're doing our defense, ito po yung usually tatanong sa so what, ano yung impact, ano yung relevance, or if you're presenting it in an audience, ito rin, no? So what yung research mo, no? The outcome, it refers to the outcome of the research, should ultimately provide useful information that somehow or some way contributes to the improvement of the community or the world. So we're hoping that your research should have relevance. It should pass the so what test. Yung outcome of the research should be used. Common na rin when we sit on the defenses, papers of our students, either sa college man yan, high school, sa master's, or sa doctoral, hinahanap na rin to. I think this is the first one na hinahanap na, no? What's the impact of the research, no? For what use are your research? So ngayon, when we have the research, we should also provide a copy of the results to the beneficiaries of our research. So when we conducted the research, for example, of an assessment of a certain industry, we should provide a copy to the industry stakeholders of such research. Kung isang school man yan, you have conducted in your school, then you should give that copy to the school, especially to the decision makers of the school. They are going to appreciate that such research has been conducted. So in a nutshell, the finer here stands for the your research should be feasible, it should be interesting, it should be novel, it should be ethical, and it should also be relevant. I think there's an illustration here. Sa next slide po, Doc Ryan. Ah, meron ko. Ah, okay. This is a research that we have conducted 2013-2014 on illustrating the relevance of a certain research. Now, yung first one, the barriers to employment and livelihood of persons with disabilities in Caloocan City, we're trying to determine all the gamut of barriers that the PWD has over his unemployment and over the difficulty of his livelihood. So ito yung dinocument namin, and this was provided to the NGO organizations, PWD organizations of Caloocan City. It was also presented in a forum that are majorly attended by PWDs. So ito po yun. Ito po yun, no? Isang research na it could illustrate to you the relevance of the research. So magagamit talaga. When we do a research, yung magagamit. And hindi lang magagamit, no, for our sake, and that is to be used in the library, no? It should be used by the stakeholders for decision making. So this was sponsored by OSAID. Yung isa dyan kasi din, the counterpart of this research, so it's a twin research. Dito naman, the employer skills and requirements. Employer skills requirements and goods and services requirements of local communities in Caloocan City. This will be for the PWDs in identify kung ano yung barriers on their side. At the same time, binalik o nagkaroon ng pivoting on the concept na itanong din yung question, alamin din sa local communities and sa employers, what are the reasons or barriers? Why are you not employing the PWDs? Or transacting, when it comes to livelihood, transacting with the PWDs. So what are their concerns? So na-document din po yan. So it's a twin research that was conducted last 2013, 2014. It was presented to them and it was used by our PWDs. Sige, Doc Ryan, okay na po. Next framework na po ako. Okay. The next framework will be the 5W1H framework in the research topic. So other than the finer as a framework to be able to evaluate the scientific merit of a research topic, meron ding isa. Meron ding isa, the 5W1H framework in research topic. But basically, this is the name of the framework. Pwedeng 5 Ws, pwedeng 5 Ws and 1 H, or the 6 Ws minsan, kasi yung H dyan ay kinukonsider ng isang W pa. These are actually questions that are basic in information gathering. So this is the who, what, when, where, why, and how. Sa journalism parlance, ito yung new style, no? Kompleto na police investigation. It can also be applied in the research. So alamin mo yung who, what, when, where, why, and how. So it's a formula of getting the complete story for an entire subject. So tingnan natin how does this apply. So let's check for the discussion. Tingnan natin kung paano natin i-apply ito. Before that discussion, allow me to give into our memory lane. I do not know if you're familiar with this book, in the group Rudyard Kipling's The Elephant Child. So there's a poem that goes, ito po yun. I keep 6 honest serving men. They taught me all I knew. So ito yung 6 honest serving men. Their names are the what, and where, and when, and how, and why, and who. I send them over land and sea. I send them east and west. But after they have worked for me, I give them all a rest. So it gives the importance. So this story gives the importance of the 6 honest men serving a person of logic or of research. No, ito rin na pwedeng gamitin. Ano ba yung what dyan? Ano ba yung where? Ano ba yung when? Ano yung how? Why? And ano yung who? So, sige sir, tuloy na po natin. So, let's start with the why and the who. When we ask the why question, we should ask the researcher or ourselves, why are we choosing this topic? What interests you about that topic? And what is its impact? So why do this research, after all, if it's not going to have an impact? So that's the question now. bakit mo pinipili yung research na to? So why choose the topic? What is your interest about this research? So it serves as the why, bakit, no? Why are we conducting the research? The who now is another frame to ask who are the information providers on this topic. These are your sample respondents or participants, so who can provide you, or the experts who can provide you on a certain topic. So this also includes, if you're going to ask the who are going to be your collaborators or partners in this research. So that's the who, the why, and the who. Doc Ryan, sorry po ulit. Ah, okay. This one is new. Hindi pa po talaga nakokompleto ito. To illustrate to you the why and the who, we're trying to make a research now on hearing the voices of selected Filipino persons with disabilities amidst the pandemic and disasters. So, well, the Mr. Richard Arsenio of the PWD sector approached us that their PWD sector is neglected in the time of pandemic and disasters. So we are documenting their voices in the time of pandemic and disasters. So ano ba po ang sitwasyon nila? What are their situation? So it's a good why, no? Why are we conducting this research? Because these people, this sector, are closer to our heart. We're working on this one. Si kami ni Dr. Redelia Macaspap from Our Lady of Fatima University, Dr. Paulino from St. Paul University, Quezon City, and this PWD leader, si Mr. Richard Arsenio. We're working on this one because we wanted to have a research that could have an impact. Yung who din dito, yun, gusto namin itanong din, no? These are the persons that are involved. Ito yung may mga puso para sa mga PWDs. And wala pang bayad to, no? Wala pang bayad. So we're trying to offer our services and our expertise to do this research para kina Mr. Richard Arsenio. And it's a good why, and it's a good who also. Who are the stakeholders? Mga PWDs po ang aming participants po dito. Okay, sige po. Okay. Ah, okay. In connection with the why kasi, there's a quote from yung Harv Eker, no, yung book author of The Secrets of the Millionaire Mind, Mastering the Inner Game of Wealth. Okay. Ang sabi niya, well, if you don't have a why, you won't have any motivation at all. So it's a good point that we should have the why in doing our research. Get a clear on why you want to achieve your goals, and you'll find all the motivation you need to work towards them. So yun po yung it's a connection that I need to make with reference to the why by Harv Eker. Sige po, sir, tuloy na po natin. There are questions pa. Okay, what and the where. For the what, my take on this one will be, what are the major questions for this topic? So this pertains to the SOP already, your statement of the problem. So ano yung mga questions, major questions for the topic that you're considering? Is there a debate about the topic? So ito yung research gap naman. What's the current situation of the research topic that you are trying to start? You're trying to conceptualize. So meron bang debate dyan? So kung meron debate, identify the research gap, because I revealed earlier that when we do a research, we're going to join the discussion of such debate. We're going to join the scholarly discussion of the scholars in the topic. So definitely we need to offer such, no, the what. And also, what are the issues and viewpoints to consider? So what are the viewpoints? If you have taken an interest on the PWD before, yung sa Caloocan City, we have two views there, the viewpoints of the PWDs and the viewpoints of the employers. We're going to take them. So what are their viewpoints? So these are also considered. That's why supposed to be isang research lang yun, pero naging twin research, because we definitely need to ask the employers also, bakit, what are your hindrances in trying to employ the PWDs. Also, in here, sa letter C, you need to consider your review of related literature. So, ano yung mga issues na nandyan? Anong mga viewpoints pa to consider? So, the where and the research locale, where is your topic important or going to be conducted? So, saan ba gagawin no, yung research topic na to? So, it also pertains to your where. Saan? At saan ito importante? So, it pertains to the research locale. The where also provides you a notion of your scope. Where is, ito ba'y local study lang? Regional? National? International? How many are the number of companies that are going to be involved? How big is going to be your number of companies, kung saan din po yan. So this is the where. Kompleto na ba ako? Meron pang isa yata. Meron pa. Sige po. Next slide, sir. When and how. Okay, when and how. The when here is, when is your topic important? Are you, well, in fairness of doing historical research, meron po talagang historical research that is not in this context, no, yung timely. But we do have historical researches that unearth several viewpoints on a certain historical events. So hindi po ito yun. May mga research po talaga na timely dapat, no, timely. So parang ngayon, the current research trends ay COVID. Kung tapos na yan, so magkakaroon na naman ng bagong research trends. So is your topic important or relevant? It also goes to show that you have current issues and debates on the matter. So is the current event or current, or is it a historical issue also? So consider also the time context of your research. Kasi may mga from 10 years, minsan sa ating mga tracer studies, that will be 5 years from now or 10 years from now, you need to examine. So that will be the time context. So that will be the when as a factor in trying to frame our research topic. Yung how, dito na yung isa na medyo sensitive, no, for the researchers. The how pertains to the process of doing the research. So, ano ba yung research design dyan? Ano yung sampling design mo? Ano yung data gathering procedures that you're going to conduct? How is the validation of your survey questionnaire or your interview guide? How is the analysis of data conducted? So, these are the how questions now. These are the how questions of the framework in choosing a research topic. This is the how. Sige, Doc Ryan, meron pa po. Oh, okay. I am now down to the last few slides that I have. I need to acknowledge here Dr. Bernadette and siguro si Dr. Richard. This was taken, lifted from the PowerPoint of Dr. Bernadette. So thank you, Dr. Bernadette. I have to borrow the Creswell's definition of research. So, well, I agree, no? Research is a process of steps used to collect and analyze information to increase our understanding of a topic or issue. So it involves three important steps. So posing a question, collecting data to answer the question, and present an answer to the question. So these are the important steps according to Creswell. Let me share to you my reflections on the steps given by Creswell. Sige po, diyan po muna, sir. Posing a question. Sa taas po, sir. Previous slide. Oh, okay, sige, sir. Dito sa pose a question, my reflection on this one would be, well, when we pose a question, it's not just a question that has popped up. It's a question that is based on our review of related literature and background of the study. This is practically our statement of the problem when we pose such question. So we just don't put questions. It should be grounded on our RRL from our theoretical framework. Anong tingin, anong viewpoint ang gagamitin natin dyan? What is the lens that we're going to use in crafting also our questions? Also, it also pertains to us that before posing such questions, we should have a background of our study also. So ito yung knowing also the research gaps. So yun po yung asking the right questions, so posing a question. That's my reflection on Creswell's step number one. Dito sa step number two, collecting data to answer the question. Okay, so this is the methodology already, the step two by Creswell. So dito po yung research research design, basically the chapter on the methodology that we have. So research design, what will be our sampling, the data gathering procedures, that how do we treat our data. So dito napapasok yung aking mga reflections on the steps given by Creswell on number two, collecting data to answer these questions. We just don't collect data, no, out of the blue. So merong procedures din po yan. Okay. In number three, present an answer to the question. Present an answer to the question. Sige po, tapusin ko muna to, then we're going to have a collegial discussion on this one. Present an answer to the question. So dito yung, bakit nilagay ko yung C? Ah, conclusions and recommendation. Findings, presentation of findings, presentation of our conclusions and our recommendations. When Creswell talks about presenting an answer to the question, well, we are presenting our findings already. We're going to make our conclusions and our recommendations. So that, I think, is my reflection for the important steps of Creswell. You may find the Creswell's thoughts limiting on the steps, pero sa tingin ko, nandun yung importanting elements when we are going to conduct research. So when we post a question, these are not simple questions. These are questions grounded on your RRL and background. These are your SOP. Collecting data, it has something to do with your research design, your methodology. And the third one, the third step of Creswell will be presenting an answer to the question. So this pertains to the presentation findings, the conclusions, and recommendations of your research. Another reflection that I have, kinuha ko rin po ito. Sige, Sir Ryan, last one. According to Creswell po. Well, according to Creswell, the same author, a researcher, before engaging in the rigors of research, design, and research methods, must consider the following. So ito yung i-consider niya. Research topic, research problem, a research problem, the purpose, and research questions. Well, on my part, this is my reflection. I do not know if Creswell intends this one as a pyramid, no, yung hierarchy. Mauna ang research topic, research problem, purposes, and research questions. Palang wala naman, pero may number kasi. Ito ba yung hierarchy? Hierarchy niya ng to consider, no? Consider mauna ang topic. Isipin mo topic mo. Isipin mo ang problem mo, isipin mo yung purpose mo, then isipin mo yung research questions mo. Dito napaisip ako. Well, by experience, sa akin ang order nito ay mauuna yung purpose minsan sa akin. Siguro, no, by experience ito yung nauna, the purpose and reason for doing the research. So, yeah, ito yung why sa akin. It's the first consideration that we should have, siguro yun ang encouragement ko, and we could discuss this one. The encouragement for researchers is to have the consideration as foremost their purpose and reason for doing the research. Then eventually, the following considerations given by Creswell can follow. We can concentrate on the research topic, the problem, and the questions. I believe doon sa pandemic natin, yung pinakita kong picture doon na merong babae na professor who contributed his research in the development of COVID vaccine. I think yung purpose is yung ang kanyang primordial consideration in doing the research is actually the purpose of providing a solution, a COVID vaccine solution to the pandemic that we have. Then the rest is going to follow. Also, it will have a certain motivation effect. Yung isang motivating effect if we have a certain purpose or reason in doing so. Sige po, Dr. Ryan. yeah, reflection lang po yan, no? Mga personal. Ah, okay. Allow me to market my school. Ito po yung offerings po namin sa MBA and psychology and PhD. So, tapos na po ako. So, we have around 7 specializations for MBA. If you wanted to enroll, if you wanted to have a second master's degree or a second PhD degree, okay po. Online po kami lahat. Online po kami lahat. So, these are the programs that we offer. Sige po. Next slide po, sir. Ah, okay. So, I have two closing words, no? I have two closing words. Minsan, with the life that we have, no? Medyo mahirap talaga, but we need to move ahead. And thankfully, we are moving ahead. And the action that we have, even if may mga researches tayo na pending, hindi talaga napapansin, napapabayaan na, but we need to continue moving forward on that. So keep moving ahead because the action creates a certain momentum, sabi ni Vujicic, which in turn creates unanticipated opportunities. So yun lang, no? Laban lang. For the researchers at heart, ito po yun, no? You may find difficulty in starting a research kasi ako ay natitigil din minsan sa research. But when you are in a group, you are in a team, you help each other, no? Uplift each other, tulak, no? Help each other push for doing the research. So maganda po. This also yung ETCOR, no? I'm thankful to ETCOR. So ito nga, no? I may have some reservations in pushing with the talk, pero carry pa rin, no? Carry pa rin because love natin ang ETCOR, love natin ang research. And everybody is going to learn somehow, no? Everybody is a teacher and everybody is a student also. Sige po, sir. Next slide yan. Meron life, purpose-driven life dyan eh. Okay, so I started with the customization of my title of presentation. It's a research-driven life. So galing po sa libro talaga na The Purpose-Driven Life by Rick Warren. So nakalagay doon. May nakalagay doon na maganda, no? Without God, life has no purpose. And without purpose, life has no meaning. And without meaning, our life has no significance. So with that, I think that's the closing. Next slide, sir. Wala na. Yeah, wala na po. Wala na po. Thank you. So I understand majority of the participants are researchers. So bear with me, no? Bear with me. Thank you po. Thank you, ETCOR. Thank you, Dr. Ryan, for helping me in my presentation.
Okay. Thank you very much po, Dr. Adrian Carvajal. Let's give him naman po a virtual clap for that very comprehensive discussion about his topic po. Wait lang po. Allow me to share my screen po. Wait lang po. Kung sakali man po that you have questions or queries po, no? You can use our chat box po.
Wait lang po. Sige. There are questions in the chat box. Sige, sir. Please read. Tapos let's join in the discussion.
Yes.
Galing pa yata kay Sir Richard yung mga tanong na to. Sige.
Doc Richard, mag-share po ako ng screen. Pwede pa ba ako mag-share ng screen, Doc?
Yes po naman, Doc. Kayo pa ba, Doc?
Wait lang. Ayun. So, share lang po ako ng screen ko po. Okay, so again, thank you very much, Dr. Adrian Carvajal po, no, for
this
topic, research-driven life, crucial questions to start your research journey. So I love the FINER and the 5W1H framework po, no. And ang pinakagusto ko sa narinig ko is we really love ETCOR. So,
lahat na po yan. Totoo yan. Mahal natin na ETCOR.
Na i-share po natin. And we know that ETCOR, in return, ay binibigay din sa atin yung knowledge, yung mga ideas, and most especially, embracing the culture of research po. No? So, with that po, and lastly, yung pinaka, ano ni Sir, no, ni Doc Adrian, I repeat this one, no, without God, life has no purpose. And without purpose, life has no meaning. And without meaning, life has no significance. So thank you very much po, no, Doc Adrian, for that po. Before po we proceed to question and answer, baka po kasi ano po tayo, may I request everyone po for a photo opportunity. Let us just open first our camera. No po, alisin ko lang po yung aking screen. Ayan. So, may I request everyone to open their cameras po. Ayan. So, Doc Richard, ikaw na magpipicture before po tayo pumursid sa ating Q&A.
I'm Doc Richard.
Okay,
I'm
ready. Sige po. Okay, 1, 2, 3. Smile po kayo. Oh, wait lang po ha. Ipipaste ko lang po.
Sige po.
Okay, yung susunod po. Ayan.
Okay, your best next smile.
Po. Okay, smile po. 1, 2, 3. Okay, okay na po.
Okay po. So, for this one po, before our evaluation po, let's have our question and answer. So, we have our chat box po, no? So, kanina po si Doc Richard mismo, our research head, question. I don't know if Doc Adrian answered this one. Dyan po sa finer framework, madalas po, alin sa limang features or aspect ng finer framework ang usually ay nakakalimutan ng mga students na nagpo-propose ng study nila sa graduate school nyo, which in return o in turn becomes the reason kaya madalas ay nare-reject ang study nila.
Okay. Let's refresh the finer framework, no? Feasibility, interesting, novelty, ethical, relevance. Okay. On my part, sa observation namin sa graduate school, yung letter F dyan ang medyo is a big consideration. Is the student capable of finishing the research? Yung feasibility. Because maraming factors dyan ang nandyan sa feasibility as a factor to consider in trying to conceptualize or start your research topic. So, nandyan yung time element, the resources that you have. It's either the external resources that you have or the your internal resources. So, minsan, sarili mo mismo will be a hindrance for you in conducting this research. So, that's the letter F. Among the letters, no, letter F, I consider it very, very critical ko lang. Na dapat makita ka agad, question on feasibility or possibility. So may mga factors doon eh, ma-identify natin. The time, the resources, the consideration of the respondents, yung how are you going to get the respondents. Minsan, sa dulo, you're going to realize, ang hirap pala. Ay, ito po talaga, no, ang nangyari. Marami kaming letters of extension, maybe because of the pandemic nga, no, they failed to foresee that after the pandemic wala pang survey questionnaire na magaganap except online. So yun yung problema nila. So these are the things that problema nila. In particular case, ito yung may isa kami sa PhD talagang naka-hold kasi doctors of hospitals ang kanyang respondent. So medyo mahirap ngayon ang paghagilap sa mga doctors po natin. They are very busy. At the same time, yung kanyang other respondents, group of respondents ay domestic tourists outside NCR. So, mahirapan din po siya. Admittedly, ako rin po, no? Kahit ako po ay hirap din, pero I was able to transfer my data gathering procedures online. Nung sa second PhD ko, nahirapan din po talaga ako niyan kasi I was intending to go to schools and do the survey questionnaire. Pero nung natanggal, wala po talaga. You need to migrate your system of data gathering online and adapt to the situation. So that's the feasibility, yung concept. I think sa other research consultants, do you have thoughts on this? Ano yung parang, of the five, no? Ano yung usually nakakalimutan ng estudyante?
So we are
or importanteng mag-consider, opo.
We are open now for other research consultants so that we can have a shared ideas and concept po.
Ano kasi yung and, ano kasi yung finer, sir? Ano kasi yung lima na yon?
Okay, feasibility.
Feasibility.
Interesting, novelty, ethical, and relevance. Yung isa dyan, sir, impact. Yung impact. Usually, when we sit in the defense, we question kaagad, impact kaagad eh. Bakit yan yung study mo? What's the impact? So, minsan. Pero dun ako sa F na, you start talaga. Yung nitty-gritty details is the F. Feasibility sa akin. Posible bang gawin yung research na yan? Anyway, sige po. Kayo sir, Richard. Oh, sige po.
Ako, sir, base sa ano mo po, based po sa explanation mo, hindi para pong I also agree with you, given na bago po yung situation natin ngayon. So yung kasing like interesting ba siya, novel ba yung study, relevant ba siya, parang ano yan eh, kumbaga mga kahit mga sa theories mo lang, mga salita mo lang, you can justify ganoon. Kaya siguro I agree with you na madalas ang pinaka weak yung mga nagpo-propose doon sa feasibility. At yung mga panel members na madalas, I'm sorry to use the word, nagre-reject siguro ng mga study or nagpapamodify, madalas siguro ang mas tinatamaan talaga nila yung dun sa feasibility, given na yung situation ngayon. At of course, additional lang yon. But kung titingnan mo talaga, ang pinaka-obvious na pwede mong tingnan ng isang study, kumbaga, I'm sorry to use the term, yung bubutasan mo yung isang study, I think I agree with you na doon sa feasibility, doon mas madalas siya makitaan ng weaknesses yung mga proposals ngayon. But that is just my observation. Baka po yung iba meron silang other observation.
Thank you, Dr. Richard. Thank you, Dr. Richard.
Others naman, Doc, no? I don't know if you have experienced this. May mga panel members na minsan sila pa yung nagkokontrahan ng changing of ideas. It's because of meron din silang sari-sariling dalang mga sabihin natin mga concept in terms of that kind of framework, no? So minsan kung ano na lang yung napag-usapan, pero mas maganda kung ano po talaga yung pinaka-feasible sa lahat ng mga studies po natin. Meron pa po, Doc, no? Doc Adrian. So sabi
nga po, marami po yan. Marami sa chat po yan. Sige po.
Babasahin lang natin. Magandang gamitin yung finer framework sa classroom. So sa ating mga nagtuturo ng research, kapag tuturuan natin ng mga students natin, ano dapat i-consider kapag magpo-propose sila ng topics nila. So pwede rin siguro gawan ng rubrics yan para may score sila per aspect ng finer framework to help us decide kung katanggap-tanggap ba yung pinopropose nilang topics.
Actually, maganda yung suggestion ni Dr. Richard ba to? Yes, it can po be, no? Tita mo, nagkaroon na naman tayo. We can use this framework in analyzing the topics of our students, no? Initially, kahit ilang estudyante yan, if you have two classes of research, pwede na pong research po to using the finer framework. So gagawa mo siya ng rubrics rating kung yung kanila mga topic ba, it falls under feasibility, interesting ba to, novelty, ethical, and R. Kasi when I presented this one, and there was a research presentation of high school students sa amin. Ginamitan ng finer framework ng mga judges. So ginamit to in judging the paper of students who are presenting. Una pa lang, yung R. Gamitin yung R. Relevant ba yung study mo? So natutukoy ka agad, no? Kung ano bang scientific meron yung isang papel na to. So maganda yung point ni Sir Richard, no? Pwedeng gamitin talaga sa pagtuturo to. Other than that, pwede na rin siyang gamitin as a research tool, yung finer framework, to be able to analyze if the topics of our students squarely is successful in passing the finer framework. Pasado ba sa F, I, E, N, E, R?
Pag nagawan mo ng Doc, pag nagawan mo ng rubric, share mo na lang, no? Share na lang. Para at least measurable yung rubric mo based on A-theory siya at nagagawa natin siyang measurable, malinaw sa bata or sa proponent, okay. Paano natin na compute yung score niya dun sa ano.
Consult ko yung aming statistician.
Huwag mong kakalimutang i-share, Doc. Thank you.
Oo, yung finer framework. magagamit yan. Pinagawa ko ng bagong trabaho ni Sir Richard. Sige po, sir. Sige, I'll give you an update of this one. Meron ba, no client?
Yes po.
Puro si Sir Richard naman nagtatanong dyan eh.
Huwag ka mag-alala, sir. Ah, Doc, meron siyang ano, meron siyang kasama dito. Siguro sige, yung sige. Kasamahan natin, ano, medyo nahihiya din yung idea.
But if they wanted to share, fellow research consultants, no, we welcome you. No, we welcome you. If you're new here, you can share also your ideas. No, we are very open of learning also from you. Sige, sir. Ano po yung mga tanong dyan?
Huwag kang mag-alala, Doc Richard. Isa-share talaga ni Doc Adrian yan because mahal na mahal niya talaga yung ETCOR, sinabi niya nung pag sa end ng topic niya. So, meron pa rin siyang isa-share sa atin.
Okay po. Naka-record yan. Naka-record.
Yung 5W, 5Ws and 1H framework naman, maganda siyang gamiting sample ng discussion within and across the curriculum contents. Discussion of research topic, tapos integration ng discussion, content sa journalism, and English po. Thank you, Dr. Richard, for that.
Dr. Rigette, may I elaborate on that?
Please elaborate.
Hindi, may mga ano po kasi tayo dito, marami po tayong mga kasama dito na nagtuturo, I think, sa DepEd. May mga school head tayo dyan, yung mismo moderator natin, school head yan ng Bacolor High School. Ako bilang isang master teacher po, trabaho po kasi natin yung nag-a-assess meron kami tinatawag na COT, yung mga classroom observation sa mga guro, particularly yung teachers 1 to 3, yung mga proficient teachers. Isa po kasi sa hinahanap, may score kasi yon, tapos nagiging part yun ng performance appraisal, yung sa RPMS ng mga nagtatrabaho sa gobyerno. Di ba Doc Rigette, merong part doon yung ang tawag dito, yung naturo mo yung content within and across curriculum. Kapag within lang, ibig sabihin, nagtuturo ka lang, halimbawa yung tinuturo mong subject sa research, hanggang doon ka lang, hindi mo siya na-integrate sa ibang mga subject, hindi mo na ipakita yung connection niya or paano mo ma-integrate yung ibang mga subject, medyo mababa yung points. Ito kasing discussion mo ng 5Ws and 1H, Doc Adrian, napakagandang gamiting sample nito ng isang discussion kung saan ma-integrate mo rin yung ibang ano, other curriculum contents or other learning areas. Halimbawa, kung di-discuss mo yan, syempre, masasama yan sa lesson plan mo. Ano yung mga dapat i-consider kapag magpo-propose ka ng topic, gagamitin mo yung 5Ws and 1H framework. And at the same time, makokonnect mo pa rin siya doon sa journalism o kaya doon sa learning area na English. Kumbaga ano na makakatulong siya, hindi ka na mag-iisip sa mga nagtuturo po sa atin ng research. Ayun na yun, pag nakita na ng nag-a-assess ng nag-o-observe sa iyon, makikita niya na yung tinuturo mo, hindi ka lang naka-box doon sa research learning area. Nakukuha mo pa siyang i-connect in the other alert. Kaya napakagandang example niya. Yun lang po. Thank you po.
I agree doon sa sinabi ni Doc Richard that that is number one of our indicator in ano po classroom observation po namin as observer po sa mga teachers in the Department of Education that your lesson should be integrated within and across the learning area. I have attendee yung aking research teacher dito sa school na kapag research yung kanya, aking ino-observe sa kanya, automatic yung number one, dapat makita ko kagad doon sa topic niya. It's because that is very evident naman po pagdating po sa research po natin. Okay? To continue po, no? Saying Doc na kahit nasa proposal stage na pa lang ang isang research proponent, kahit papaano ay may idea na rin dapat siya sa mga procedures, sa method dissection, at ng topic na pinopropose niya. Tama po ba ang aking pagkakaunawa? Kumbaga, kahit hindi niya fully alam ang buong detalye ng method section niya, at least ay may idea na siya sa general flow ng method niya, kahit nasa proposal pa lang siya ng topic. So kumbaga ang tinatanong dito, even though na hindi niya alam yung Doc Richard, what do you mean here? Yung pong methods
parang ano
niya,
Doc? Kasi 'di ba ang coverage pa lang ng discussion ni Dr. Carvajal ngayon is paano ba pumili ng best topic? Paano ba yung mga dapat i-consider kapag nagpo-propose ka? Kaya lang kasi doon lumitaw doon sa framework niya na 5Ws and 1H, lalo na yung doon sa how. Di ba yung mga dinidiscuss niyo dun sa how yung like ano yung research design, ano yung mga tool na gagamitin mo. Kaya parang ang dating sa akin, doon sa framework kung gagamitin mo yung 5 W's in 1H, parang ang dating sa akin, kahit nasa proposal stage ka pa lang, hindi mo pwedeng sabihin na halimbawa ang panel, naku ba't nagtatanong na siya sa method, anong method ang gagamitin ko? Nasa topic proposal pa lang ako. Pero ang dating sa akin ng 5 W's in 1H, particular din sa 1H, sa H, kumbaga kahit nagpo-propose ka pa lang ng topic, kahit nandun ka pa lang sa part na iyon, dapat meron ka na at least a glimpse ng method section mo. Hindi pwedeng totally hindi mo alam. Kumbaga, the panelists will not ask you na ano na dapat alam mo in detail anong research design niya, sinong magiging respondents mo, paano mo sila napili, paano mo na... Kumbaga, kahit hindi mo 100% alam yung detalye, bilang nagpo-propose, kahit nandun ka pa lang sa proposal stage, at least may overview ka na. Tama po ba yung pagkakaunawa ko, Doc Carvajal? Pwede kang kumontra, no? Wala namang ano, wala namang laglagan dito. Biro lang po.
Doc Richard, medyo intermittent na yung connection ko o ikaw. Pero well explained, Sir Richard. And you got my point. Even in the early stages of the research, dapat may idea ka na ng methods mo or kung sino ang mga kukunin mo mga respondents. That will make your life easier kung feasible ba to o hindi. Yung sa how to eh. So dapat talaga, no? If you're also a seasoned researcher, pag merong may alam ka na kagad, medyo holistic ka na tumingin eh. Itong research na ba to, sino ang respondents natin? Ano ang method? Quanti, quali, SQ, interview guide. So, alamin mo kaagad yun eh. That will make your life easier and that will make your counsel sa estudyante easy also. Matatanong mo na rin kung ito yung mga tanong na dapat malaman. Kahit shallow lang, no? Ideas lang nila. Oh. Tama ka. Well said.
Kumbaga, no, hindi mo pwedeng sabihan ng panel member na, wait lang po, masyadong excited, nasa topic proposal pa lang ako, may tanong na sa method. No? Parang hindi pwede yung ganun kasi parang kasama na agad. Once na nag-propose ka ng topic, at least, yun nga, medyo may ano ka na rin, ano yung, paano yung procedures kahit hindi pa fully na detalyado, no, Doc? Thank you po.
Okay. Sir Richard, clarify ko lang, ha? In the perspective of the advisor, dapat alam niya lahat kung siya yung nag-counsel. Pero merong limitations din kasi ang panel members. Pag sinabing proposal defense lang, well, hopefully proposal defense lang yung mga tanong. Proposal defense lang yung tanong. Yun yung para nakita kong reservation. Reservation doon, Sir Richard.
Yes, hello po. Yes, sir.
Yun.
Yes po, sir. Yes po, Doc.
Yun sana yung gusto kong matutunan ng mga estudyante ko. Sabi ko nga yung gusto kong i-train, na-inspire ako sa talk mo. Gusto kong i-train yung mga estudyante ko ngayon dahil tapos na yung school year yung mga padating niyan na kahit proposal pa lang, kahit papaano ay dapat ready din sila sa ganoon. Although sabi mo nga, may reservation ka rin doon kasi baka naman merong ibang panel na sumobra na tipong wait, parang masyado na tayong napapa-advance sa mga tanong natin sa mga estudyante. Kaya kung minsan, marami namang mga estudyante ang nadi-discourage, no? Kasi parang ito lang pinaghandaan nila, kaya lang ikaw marunong ka na, expert ka na, ito na pala yung mga tanong mo masyado ng malayo. Thank you, Doc. Thank you.
Oo. Sir, additional pala, no? I remember, sa proposal defense kasi, chapter 1 to 3 plus SQ or interview guide, tama, no? Sa kung ganun, no? Sa proposal defense, I do not know sa high school kung if you follow that. Sa proposal defense, it follows na discussion or questioning of chapter 1, 2, 3, kasama ang survey questionnaire or interview guide. So tama, i-question talaga yon. So sa chapter 3 kasi, sir, method, nandun na yung population sample. So dapat alam na ng estudyante kung ano yung balak niya, no? Before siya mag-start ng administration of survey questionnaire or start ng kanyang interview guide or ng qualitative interviews, mga ganun. Oh, sige, sir. Tama ka dun, sir. Kasama na pala sa proposal stage. Share ko lang, no? Meron akong na-meet na kwan naman to, no? Mas, syempre, may mga we honor also our old researchers, no, may mga matatanda na sa atin na kung merong flip classroom, meron siyang flip research, yung concept niya, no, baliktad naman, nauuna yung anong tawag dito? Nauuna yung finding. So alam na niya yung result, pero i-shoot niya doon sa i-shoot niya. But we do not encourage that one, no. May proseso pa rin yung research dapat. So sa kanya flip. There are answers that deserves that are looking for questions. Baliktad yun eh sa kanya. Questions that are posed and we look for answers. Yung sa kanya, there are questions, there are answers that we're going to look for the right questions. So yun yung baliktad yung sa kanya eh. Share ko lang, no? At least to honor that person. May point ba siya o meron ba? Yun ang kanyang one way ng kanyang paggawa ng research also is different. But for us, na medyo meron ng karanasan ng konti, kung talaga, no, we look at the research holistically. Dapat when we begin the research, alam na natin dapat ang ating method na gagamitin, sampling, pati statistics, no, dapat alamin mo na kung ano yung gagamitin mo para we could anticipate the procedures that we're going to pursue. Sige po. Dr. Ryan, okay na po ako. Sorry for sharing.
Yes, it's okay po. We are learning po from your experiences and expertise, no po. And I agree with that. Ang meron ako na rin na panel na ganoon eh. Ang tawag niya reverse engineering. No, parang baliktad yung pagkaka.
Oo, may mga terms silang ganyan, reverse engineering. Baliktad nila yung research eh.
Minsan sa kanila mo naririnig yan eh, yung ating mga talagang experts natin talaga ng mga medyo may edad na po pagdating sa research po. Meron din tayong mga ano dito, Doc, from Sir Michael Parado. I agree that the purpose must comes first. And from Doc Richard, ang sabi, may discount ba ang mga taga-ETCOR pag nag-enroll sa San Sebastian, Doc Adrian?
Meron po, no? Meron pong discount at meron din pong tawag to help from the ETCOR community or family. So meron po.
Oh, yun po. Online ba yan, Doc?
If you want or... to. Online po yan. Thank you, Sir Richard. Online.
Sige po. From Ma'am Mary Jane Magnotan, thank you, sir, for the inspiring talk. From Maria Luisa De Vera, thank you so much, Dean Carvajal, for sharing your expertise and wisdom to all of us. From Sir Alberto Dizon, short yet precise. Thank you, sir. And from Doc Richard ulit, hindi mo naman kami binigo, Doc Adrian. So even though that we have technicalities, naibigay mo pa rin yung kailangan mong ibigay sa amin. At the same time, we learned a lot from your expertise and experience po ninyo. Before the evaluation form, another one from Sir Aldrick Licaros. Thank you so much, Doc Speaker. I learned a lot from the lecture. From Ma'am Morilla. Yes po, Doc. Malaking tulong. Siguro ito yung mga conversations natin kanina. Opo.
Opo.
Again, from Sir Aldrick. Yes, I agree with Doc Richard. The 5 W's and 1 H is a good way to integrate across disciplines. So yun nga po, no, especially sa mga taga-DepEd po talaga, that the first indicator po in their classroom observation is to integrate within and across learning areas and disciplines po. Another one from Sir Aldrick Licaros. I think the 5 W's and 1 H is also a nice way in developing the research questions because may part na nagkukwenta ka. However, pwede din backupan ng kwento. Not only quantitative data but much better to be back up with reflection by saying. So am I right, Doc Speaker? Yung how siguro ito. Yung how, ano niya, yung discussion kanina.
Opo. Hello, Doc Moderator.
Sige
po. Hello, Doc Moderator. Good evening.
Yes, good evening po. Yes, sir. Mas maganda po.
Good evening, Doc Speaker and Doc Richard. Okay. Salamat po dahil ang dami kong natutunan through the lecture of our Doc Speaker. Actually, i-clarify ko lang yung katapusan ko na sinabi. Siguro no, iba-iba man ang ano natin, it could be ano tayo doon sa tinatawag na quantitative research. Meron namang hiyang doon sa tinatawag na qualitative research. Meron namang mixed method. Siguro itong 5 W's with 1 H, sinasabi ko kanina doon sa King Chat na maganda din siya i-ano sa ating research questions. Dahil sometimes ay kinukuha lang natin yung performance sa mga teachers sa DepEd. Kinukuha lang natin yung performance sa mga bata and nagkukonclude tayo kaagad through grades, through post-test, through scores sa ating assessment. However, mayroong mga hindering factors or tinatawag na underlying variables na hindi natin alam. Ano ba talagang dahilan? Bakit nagkaroon ng ganitong performance? Bakit naglo-low, lalong-lalo na during pandemic time? Bakit nagahayong iba na noong unang panahon during face-to-face, maliit man ang performance. Yung iba ay lumiliit from higher performance or performing well. Yung iba naman ay lumiliit from higher to lower performances. Siguro it's better na babak-upan ng tinatawag na kwento or the history behind bakit nagkaroon ng ganun, no? Or tinatawag na reflection. That is why the how question siguro vital doon sa tinatawag na reflection. Bakit pa nagkaroon ng ganun? Ito namang what is the difference between yung mga ganun, God, in the beginning, parang kinukuha natin yung tinatawag na kwenta or yung numero sa ating learners. Bakit ganito ang numero sa ating learners na ganito ang kanilang performances? However, para maging founded talaga siya, strong ang dating, babak-upan natin ang reflection from the learners. Bakit kaya nagkaroon ng ganito? Using the modular distance learning, using LAS. I don't know in Manila kung uso ba dyan sa DepEd yung LAS, yung learning activity sheet.
Yes po. May ginagamit din po namin yung mga learning activity sheet po.
Okay. So
yes po, gumagamit din po kami.
Opo, oo. Actually, ang daming tinatawag na history behind doon sa learning performances ng mga bata. It could be lumalaki ang scores kasi nagtatagna lang tayo dahil iba ang sumasagot, no? Mayroon namang talagang nagsusunog ng kilay para masagutan yung ating mga last. Pero much better na babakapan ng story or reflection coming from the learners. That is why I really appreciated the 5 W's with 1 H dahil masyado itong vital sa mga researchers natin. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much po. Thank you po.
Doc Rigette.
Yes po.
Hindi ko sure kung tamang pagkakaunawa ko sa sharing ni Dr. Licaros. Correct me if I'm wrong, Dr. Licaros. Si Dr. Licaros siya ang research coordinator sa kanilang division sa Cotabato, no, Doc? Tama po ba?
Yes, Doc Richard.
Opo, opo. Yes, parang ang pagkakaunawa ko sa sharing ni Doc Licaros, yung kasing sa akin kanina yung na-appreciate ko yung 5 W's and 1 H sa pag-integrate ng lesson within and across curriculum. Siya naman, na-appreciate niya yung 5 W's and 1 H sa kung paano natin dapat i-assess ang mga bata, ang mga estudyante sa panahon ngayon, lalo na ngayon na ano, ngayon na panahon ng pandemic. Kumbaga somehow, merong konting please don't get me wrong sa word na gagamitin. Parang mayroong konting sermon yung kay Dr. Licaros, no? Kumbaga pag nag-assess tayo ng mga bata ngayon, mas lawakan pa natin tayong mga nagtuturo, mga educators, mas lawakan pa natin hindi lang isang tanong kung pwedeng gamitin mo yung 5 W's and 1 H para malaman mo bakit kaya ganito. Hindi lang, huwag ka lang tingin ng tingin, sabi nga niya dun sa kwenta, tingnan mo yung kwento ng mga estudyante mo. Salamat po.
Thank you very much, Doc Richard and Doc Licaros, for that sharing po. Doc Adrian, I think this is the last question po. from MJ Biazon. Hi Doc, maiba lang po. Pwede po bang itanong yung difference ng ratio at interval variable?
Hello po.
Yes, Doc.
Allow me to call my statistician for that to answer this one. Hindi ko po masasagot po yan. So there are things that I am capable of answering, but this one, hindi ko po masasagot. Doc Richard, kaya mo to?
Meron tayong mga experts sa stat ngayon na nandito po sa... Okay. Ayoko lang pangalanan, but pwede po silang sumagot. Kasama natin sa ETCOR.
Although this is not part, pero we can entertain, no? For purposes of learning.
Yes po.
Meron po. Meron pong sasagot nito.
Pakiulit sa question, Doc.
What is the difference po of ratio and interval variable?
So it will take 2 hours to explain this one.
Possible po there are some ano tawag dito?
I think hindi siya variable but statistical tool to be applied because itong tinatawag na interval variable. What we call variable or yung sinasabi ng variable, it is like somewhat like a scaling wherein okay. We'll start it from 1.00 going to say 1.49. Alimbawa, ano ang ating like a scaling is ranging from 1 to 5. Okay, so from 1.00 to 1.49 kasi pwede siya ma-round down into 1. Then 1.50 to 2.49. Pwede siyang ma-round off to 2.00. Then 2.50 going to 3.49. Hanggang makaabot tayo sa 5.0. However, itong ratio, ito yung, I think, the part of the sampling procedure wherein there is what we call anong tawag doon? Sandali lang.
I think, again, meron din yung questions from Sir Alberto Dizon.
Okay.
No, sir. I'll just answer yung difference between ratio and interval po. Hello, sir?
Yes, po. Apo.
Yes, po.
Okay. So, the difference between, I think, it's my personal note, between ratio and interval, when it comes to interval po, zero has a value po or zero has a meaning po. For example, the score of zero, the scores of the students in a particular exam, that is basically an interval because zero doesn't mean that particular student has no acquired information about the particular subjects. On the other hand, ratio means zero has an absolute value, meaning to say it's nothing. It doesn't have any, what they call this, description or significance. For example, weight, age, kapag sinabing zero, meaning to say it has no particular significance. But I think that's the difference between a ratio and interval. For example, the age. What is age a ratio or an interval? I think it's a ratio. Kapag kasi sinabing 0 year year old, ibig sabihin that particular child is not that particular person or individual is not existing. On the other hand, kapag sinabing, for example, time naman, is it a ratio or interval? Time is again, it's a ratio. Kasi kapag sinabing 0 millisecond, 0 minute, meaning to say that particular action is not being conducted yet. I think that's my idea between the difference of a ratio and interval po.
Thank you very much po, Sir Alberto. At yan, ito yung mga sinasabi ni Dr. Richard kanina. Yes po, Sir Emmanuel Paulino po. And then after niya, si Ma'am Angelyn Pangilinan po.
I'll just offer another explanation lang sa interval and ratio. When it comes kasi sa interval, interval and ratio are ay data types, no, numerical data types. When we talk about interval ratio, the interval data type, it means that the values between the numbers are equal. For example, we value 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, their interval are the same. Parang 1 to 5, 5 to 10, 10 to 15. When we say ratio, ito po yung we can accommodate decimals. Kasi nga nag-ratio kayo, 2 is to 1, pwede ka mag 3 is to 5. So yung fraction, pwede siyang fraction at yung pwede rin siyang maging decimal. At least in research terms, pagpapasok tayo, for example, ng values na for data analysis, sometimes yung ratio, it is usually converted into decimal. Kumbaga, pwede kang gumamit ng 12.5. So pag ratio, hindi kailangang sakto yung differences between values. Kasi for example, ang value mo 1.5, 2.2, pwedeng ganun. Pero pag interval, ang assumption is yung mga values have equal intervals, have equal differences between each other. Yun lang po.
Thank you very much po, Doc. Emmanuel Paulino po. Next po, another ideas from Ma'am Angelyn Pangilinan.
Hello, good evening po sa lahat. Thank you. If I may just add po, actually I strongly agree with the two previous fellow consultants here. So when we talk about this interval and ratio, actually they are under the concept of the level of measurement, wherein we have basically the nominal ordinal and then the interval and of course the ratio. Since the question is about the last two, which is the interval and ratio, when we talk about interval, as it was mentioned by the two, yes, it's all about the difference known or similarity at saka difference ng interval. To make my point clear, like for example, yung na-mention ni sir that there is no true zero point, that is for interval, which meant when we say 0 degrees centigrade, that doesn't mean that there is no hotness or coldness. Okay, so as we do know, we have a negative degrees. When we say 0 AD, it doesn't mean walang time before 0 AD. There is. So there is no true value for zero. Unlike for ratio, it is I also agree that it has absolute value. Like for example, when I say I do not have money in my pocket, that means I do not have money. There's a true value, okay? And then when we are getting, like for example, the weight, we are starting from zero. Okay, and if I may add with the interval, I strongly agree, sir, na kapag nagpa-quiz ka zero ang estudyante, that doesn't mean walang alam si estudyante. There might be reason na naka-zero siya. Baka wala siya during the time that the discussion with that absent siya. That is why naka-zero. Okay, so I believe that is just an additional concept based on the what my note is.
Thank you po, Ma'am Anjali. Thank you very much to all those who shared the ano po, no, their expertise about that question. And yung pong nagtanong natin si Ma'am or Sir MJ Biazon, siguro na enlightened na siya dun sa mga sharings din po natin, no po. Meron lang akong ano dito, baka na ano lang si Ma'am Mary Jane Magno about the what I have shared about the word reverse engineering. Kumbaga, yun lang po ay term na nagamit nung narin nakasama ko doon sa panel, kasi parang nagkaroon lang ng parang confusion doon sa process. No, kumbaga, imbes na ang process niya is 1 to 3, ang ginawa ng process ng nagpipresent is 3 to 1. So, pero hindi naman siya totally involved doon sa tinatawag nating research processes. Kumbaga, naging term lang niya kasi yung nag-comment doon is an engineer po, no? But then, wala pa naman akong nakita or narinig na naging term specific siya doon. Kumbaga ano lang po niya, na i-share lang po, kumbaga sa kanyang word lang po yun. Okay po. So with that po, kasi time check po tayo, it's 8:25, no po. So thank you very much po to those who shared their expertise and mga ideas po nila, no? And to award this certificate, oh, meron pala tayong evaluation form. Nakikita niyo po siya sa ating chat box. Nilagay na po ni Dr. Richard. So, please have this one para po sa ating certificate. And for our resource speaker, let me read his certificate. ETCOR Educational Research Center, Santa Ana, Pampanga, Philippines, presents this certificate of recognition to Dr. Adrian Lawrence P. Carvajal, Research Consultant, ETCOR Educational Research Center, for his invaluable time and expertise as a resource speaker in the National Webinar on Quantitative Research of ETCOR Educational Research Center held on June 23 and July 7 and 21, 2021, and conducted under the advocacy Project Sagip Mananaliksik for Everyone. So this with advisory from the Department of Education, signed by the overall project, Dr. Bernadette Leharde and Dr. Richard Sanchez. So let's give him a virtual clap. Thank you, Doc Adrian Carvajal. And for our next event, no po, this is a back-to-back Adrians of our ETCOR. So this will be on July 14, Living, Loving, and Exploring. Doing Qualitative Research, an Avenue to Meaningful Existence. So this is on July 14, 2021. Okay po? And for some advertisement po, so we have our ETCOR Educational Research Center t-shirt po, no? So this is from ano po, blueprint shop of one of our ETCOR consultant, Dr. Mark Joseph Sangil. So part of this, ano po, ay meron po tayong, anong tawag dito? Meron po tayong makukuha or we are only beneficiary of certain percentage of the sales. So if you want to have this one, you can chat Dr. Mark Joseph Sangil in his Facebook account. So with that po, no? For our closing message, let us hear that Dr. Francis A. Gumawa, a teacher 3 and research coordinator of Knights of Columbus Elementary School of San Roque, Antipolo City, Rizal. Doc Francis.
Hello po, good evening po. Narinig na po ako, sir?
Yes po, loud and clear.
Okay po. So, good evening to all po. I would like to take this opportunity po to thanks the following person po who made this concept turn into reality po. Project Sagip Mananaliksik for Everyone, Dr. Adrian Lawrence P. Carvajal, our lecturer for today, Dr. Rigette Ryan S. Ramos, our moderator, Ms. Angelyn C. D. Tioco, Dr. Richard Sanchez, our head of ETCOR Educational Research Center, all regional coordinators and research consultants of ETCOR. With these people po, we are not here in virtual today. The new knowledge that we have acquired today will be our age and be useful in the future for our students. So let us not forget to support all the activities of the ETCOR. Before I close this virtual activity po, I would like to share this simple adage. A good education is a foundation for a better future. Again po, congratulations to all. Good luck po, God bless po, at mabuhay po tayong lahat. Good evening po.
Thank you very much po, Doc Francis A. Gumawa. So with that po, no po, so Thank you very much sa lahat po ng mga nag-attend ng ating day 2 of our webinar for this quantitative research. I hope and I pray na mas darami pa po tayo, kaya nga we are bigger, better, and stronger at core. So with that po, thank you very much sa lahat. Thank you.